How can we use an age-old text to understand the case of child refugees Lily and Howick? Do you remember Lily and Howick? 2 years ago, they were all over the news. These two children had lived in the Netherlands for almost all their lives. They speak Dutch, have Dutch friends, and feel Dutch. They are rooted in this society. But Lily and Howick had to go back to their mother's home country of Armenia. Why? Because their request for asylum was denied. According to the law, they could not stay. Instinctively, we all felt this was wrong. We really hoped that the laws could have been different. Could there be another system of law that would have ruled fairly for these children? Well, there might be. And the answer lies in a very old text from India. Let me take you back in history. In the 18th century, the British East India Company had colonized what is today known as India. The British thought it would be nice if the Indian people would be governed by their own laws. Thus, in 1772, Governor Warren Hastings decided that all Hindus would be subject to the Hindu law. The British asked where this Hindu law could be found, and the pandits pointed towards this text, the Manava Dharma Shastra. In the Sanskrit language, this means a treatise on Dharma by Manu. However, the British did not know anything about this weird word Dharma. In fact, the British did not speak a single word of Sanskrit. They made several attempts to understand the text, but it was a mess. Not only it was a mess because the British did not understand the language, but also because the text looked so different from what they were used to in law codes. If you have a society, problems and disputes will inevitably arise. So to prevent the society to end up in utter chaos, you need something to govern it and settle disputes. In the West, we call this the law. Law is systematic, written down in a code, and all laws are the same for everyone. Lily and Howick were sent back to Armenia because the rule is that if your asylum application is denied, you should return to your home country. The fact that the asylum request took years to be decided didn't matter, because you cannot let the law apply to the one person but not to the other. That would be too random and, in theory at least, unfair. But for Dharma, a rule does not necessarily apply to all people the same. In the Dharma system, the specific situation and people involved are taken into account. So, in the case of Lily and Howick, it would have been taken into account that their asylum request took years. Making them rooted in that society in the process. If we had used Dharma rules, Lily and Howick might have been allowed to stay. By looking at this old text, Manava Dharma Shastra, we can see that there are other ways to govern society than law. I want to understand what this weird word, Dharma, is. We can learn from other systems such as Dharma ways to improve our law system, so that in the future, children such as Lily and Howick will get a decision which feels just and fair.